I'm in SimCenter Test Lab Neo Process Designer. And today I'm going to do some processing on a stress time history and check out the effects of mean stress correction. You can see here this stress time history definitely has a mean offset. It's in tension. So I'm going to grab that. I'm going to put that in the input basket. And now that it's in the input basket, we're going to process it. I need to do first some extraction of the cycles. I can do that with the rainflow analysis here. Connect that up. From the rainflow, we can calculate some range pairs. And from there, I can calculate some range pair damage. In fact, I don't have to keep dragging. I can also just double click here. And if I want, I can look at the properties of any one of these. And for this range pair, if I click here, I can see the SN curve that's going to be used to calculate the damage. All right, so I'll hit run. It's done processing. The results are temporarily in this active analysis. If I like them, I can hit accept. But let's take a look at this range pair damage. So here I have the stresses, the stress cycle amplitude, and it shows me how much damage accumulates for the cycles of those amplitude till I get to a normalized percentage of 100%. Now, to see the effect of mean stress correction, I'm going to add a mean stress correction element here. And I'll take that from the rain flow, and then I'll take the output of this mean stress and put it back here. I'll check out the mean stress correction properties here, and maybe I'll set that to a Goodman mean stress correction. Now I'm going to hit reject. I'll hit run. And now I'll have one time history without mean stress correction, the other one with mean stress correction. And there's a big difference here. We got with the Goodman mean stress correction, a lot more damage accumulated relative to having no mean stress correction. All right. Well, let's maybe try another one of these mean stress correction algorithms. I'll grab mean stress here again. And let's see, I'll take that output of that rainflow and come back to the range pair. So now I can compare it against the second mean stress correction method. And I'll pick something like a four segment mean stress correction. I'll hit reject here, press run again, and now I have three damage calculations here. Goodman, which is conservative, has the highest amount of accumulated damage. The four segment correction has a lesser amount, and then the no mean stress correction has the smallest amount. Again, this time history was in net tension. So when we look at it, it had an offset. So we would expect tension to create more damage, and indeed it did when we used mean stress correction. If this was in compression, the opposite would be true. The damage would be less than if we had not corrected for the mean stress. Thank you, and I hope that was helpful in understanding mean stress corrections.